गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट इम्प्लांटेशन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट प्रेगनेंसी एंड एम्ब्रियोनिक डेवलपमेंट। सो नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द टॉपिक। यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन प्रेगनेंसी एंड एम्ब्रियोनिक डेवलपमेंट। आफ्टर द इम्प्लांटेशन प्रोसेस हैज टेकन प्लेस, द ट्रोपोब्लास्ट लेयर विच इज द आउटर मोस्ट लेयर ऑफ द ब्लास्टोसिस्ट develop a finger-like projections, which is called as chorionic villi. Now, chorionic villi are surrounded by uterine tissues, and together with the uterine tissues, this gets integrated with the chorionic tissue as such, and they together jointly form a structural and functional unit, which is called as placenta. Now, placenta is a structure which is formed out of two tissues, both maternal as well as fetal. Now, the function of placenta is to provide food, nutrients and oxygen from the mother's body to the fetus body. Moreover, the undigested substances such as carbon dioxide or undigested substances, they can be removed with the help of placenta. Now, placenta directly do not joins with the fetus. Placenta, it gets connected with the fetus with the help of umbilical cord. Umbilical cord is a structure which connects the placenta with the fetus. Now, placenta itself is an endocrine gland. It secretes many kinds of hormones. Now, let us discuss about them. The first hormone is it is human chorionic gonadotropin, as you can see on the screen. Human placental lactogen, estrogens, progesterones, progestrogens, etc. Moreover, in the later phase of the pregnancy, another kind of hormone is secreted, which is called as relaxin. Now, three kinds of hormone: human chorionic gonadotropin, human placental lactogen and relaxin. These are only secreted at the time of pregnancy. Now, apart from these hormones, there are certain other hormones where the concentration becomes very high. What are they? For example, cortisol, which is secreted by adrenal glands, adrenal cortex of the adrenal glands. They secrete cortisol. The work of the cortisol is to increase the blood sugar level. Then thyroxin, the secretion of thyroxin becomes very high. Prolactin, which stimulates milk ejection during the time of childbirth. Progesterone, estrogens. So these are the hormones where the concentration of these hormones become very high, and they are responsible for proper development of the fetus. Apart from that, they take a very important role in the metabolism process of the female. Now, the proper growth, the metabolism, the correct metabolism of the mother is very essential for the proper growth of the child in the womb. So, now, this is the figure representing the development of the embryo inside the womb or the uterus, you can say. Now, the gestation period in case of human female is about 9 months. During the first month, the heart is formed and the sound of the heart can be heard with the help of a stethoscope. In the second and third month, especially in the second month, hands and digits are formed. In the third month, most of the organ system, including the genital system, is formed, is completely developed. In the fifth month, you can observe the hairs present on the body, as well as the first movement of the fetus is usually observed in the fifth month. In the sixth month, all the major organs, including the eye, lashes, ears, is completely developed and you can say the child is ready, but still the gestation period takes about 9 months because various kind of other things including the neural development is complete after the child attains 9 months as such. And finally, after 9 months, the birth of a child takes place. The period between the 0 month till 1 till 9 month is called as gestation period. That is during the which the fetus develops inside the womb and now it is ready for getting ejected outside the female body. That whole period is called as gestation period. Now let us talk about part duration and lactation. The average duration of the human pregnancy is about 9 months, which is called as gestation period. Now vigorous contraction occurs in the uterus at the end of the pregnancy, which leads to expulsion or the delivery of the fetus. Now this process is a very complex process. It is a neuroendocrine mechanism through which this takes place. Now initially mild contraction of the uterus occurs due to the developed fetus as well as placenta. They signal the mild contraction of the uterus. Now because of this mild contraction, oxytocin hormone is released. Now the concentration of oxytocin hormone increases as the uterus further contracts. This leads to more stronger contraction. More stronger uterine contraction ultimately leads to expulsion of the developed fetus. During the time of development of the embryo inside the womb, there is a differentiation in the mammary gland and it starts to produce milk at the end of the pregnancy, and this process is called as lactation. The first formed milk is called as colostrum. It is highly rich in antibodies, especially IgA, various kind of antibodies that serve as a passive immunity. You can say at the time of the birth, the immunity which is given to the child, and that is very important. Okay, now let us talk about the homework assignment. Write the importance of placenta. As I have already told you, placenta is an organ which is formed due to combination of maternal tissue as well as the fetal tissue. It is responsible for providing nutrition, oxygen from the mother's blood to the child, to the fetus, as well as expulsion of various kind of waste material from the fetal body to the maternal body. It is not directly jointed to the fetus, it is jointed through umbilical cord. So that is the importance of placenta. Moreover, it serves as an endocrine gland secreting various kind of hormones which play various roles in order to maintain the pregnancy, in order to maintain, or you can say in order to stabilize the metabolism of the female for the proper development of the fetus inside her womb. So that is all about placenta. Hormone release, I have already told you during the time of pregnancy. Now briefly explain the development of fetus in the womb. Right from the first month to the ninth month, I have already told you when the heart is formed, when the hand and digits are formed, when whole genital system is formed, when hairs appears on the body. So that all you have to write, which is given in the NCERT. I hope you like my lecture. Thank you and have a nice day.